In the game industry, we generally aim to keep the number of triangles in 3D models as low as possible. Sometimes we need to use more. No one wants to play football with a cube. But whenever possible, we use tricks to make our virtual worlds look detailed and realistic. Take a look at this example. Light bounces between bricks and even of decals on the wall. Yet the entire scene is made up of just two triangles. How is that possible? The answer lies in something called a normal map. At first glance, it might look just like a colorful noise, but there's much more to it. What does it mean? How do we read it properly? Let's find out. Welcome here. My name is Pavel, I work in game development, and I'm a former graphics developer and researcher with a PhD in computer science. Before diving deeper, let's quickly recap how lightning works in 3D graphics. When light hits a surface, its brightness depends on the angle between the light ray and the surface direction. The more directly the surface faces the light, the more light reflects towards us. We know that computers are essentially big calculators, so how can we express in the language of mathematics whether a surface is turned toward the light or in the opposite direction? Let's take a vector perpendicular to the surface pointing outward from our object. By checking this vector, we can determine the surface's position relative to the light. The closer this angle is to 90 degrees, the less light is reflected towards us. This vector is called normal vector. To understand normal maps, we first need to talk about normal vectors. A normal vector is essentially an arrow that points perpendicular to a surface. Imagine a flat table, its normal vector would point straight up. Now tilt the table slightly, the normal vector tilts with it. And here's the catch. Having details would require millions of polygons, that's where normal maps come into play. They simulate this detail without adding extra geometry. A normal map cleverly cheats by altering these normal vectors virtually. Instead of relying on actual geometry, it encodes tiny variation in surface direction into an image file. This image file uses colors R, G, and B to represent X, Y, and Z coordinates of these virtual normals. Red is X-axis, green is Y-axis, and blue is Z-axis, depth or outer direction. By interpreting these colors as directions, your GPU can make a flat surface appear bumpy or textured without adding extra polygons. A normal map texture always encodes normals in XYZ coordinates, but how the game engine interprets and transforms them into object space or world space depends on its coordinate system. Normal maps function in tangent space, meaning the normals they store are relative to the surface itself. In this context, the z-axis in the normal map always points outward from the surface, regardless of whether the engine uses different up axes in this world space. That is why they are mostly bluish or purplish. Different engines use different mappings. For example, some treat z as up, while others use y as up. Some engines even flip the green y channel. DirectX uses y plus, while OpenGL uses y minus. Engines like Godot might even swap z and y entirely, changing how normals are mapped. From a mathematical perspective, it doesn't matter. As long as you understand the principles, program your own engine or renderer in a way which is the closest to your heart. If you find it confusing, for instance, why Y should sometimes be negative or other times positive for the up direction, realize that in math, zero is the bottom left and Y gets bigger as you move up. However, in raster graphics, like your display, zero is at top left and Y gets bigger as you go down. Which approach is correct? Well, neither. Choose whatever you prefer. And don't forget to spam internet discussions and your colleagues about why your choice is the only correct one. They will love it. So to make these normals work correctly within their own coordinate system, the engine applies a TBN matrix, short for tangent, bitangent, and normal. This matrix transforms the tangent space normals into object or world space. We got normals that behave accurately regardless of how the engine handles its axis. You can also transform all light-related vectors into tangent space and compute everything there instead, if you prefer. We usually don't do that nowadays, but hey, you are welcome to do so. There you have it. Normal maps are one of the heroes of modern graphics technology. They allow us to enjoy detailed visuals without sacrificing performance. Without normal maps, content creators, artists, would face a choice. Either create highly detailed models with millions of polygons that would bring any system to crawl, or use simple flat-looking models that would preserve performance but look unrealistic. These purple-colored images solved it and allowed us to enjoy details even on less performant mobile devices. Thanks for watching! If you enjoyed this breakdown and want to see more in the future, hit the subscribe button. See you next time.